Hi there. In this tutorial, I'm going to talk about the basics of how to do a sort of vector graphics effect like this. So I'm not going to go into a lot of detail on animation or anything like that. I cover that in various other tutorials. The idea for this one is to show how you can create this colourful vector graphics look, sort of a 1980s-ish arcade game look. So it's pretty straightforward. So to begin with, let's just create a few objects that we can start to do this effect on. And I did this in Eevee. It will work just as well in Cycles, but Eevee is obviously a generally quicker render. So I've changed over to Eevee here. So let's just make some shapes. I'm just going to add a plane there, add some cuts to it there, and I'll add some cuts there as well, and perhaps one there. And I'm just going to raise that side up slightly and lower that one. So we'll call that floor. So I'm now just going to add a modifier, which is a mirror modifier, and we'll do that on the Y. And if I select all the vertices in edit mode, I can now just move this out and we'll turn on clipping just to the point where it joins together like that. And now I'll add an array modifier, which we'll set to 0 on X and 1 on Y. And then we'll just put quite a few more of them on, probably too many. We'll just put 100 there, and you can see that creates our little road that runs off into the distance. One of the things that's important about the method we're going to use, which is freestyle, is the angle that these various points are at. So the angle between, for example, this face and this face are what determine whether a line is created. So we may need to alter that, but let's just add a cube in and we'll create some additional geometry there. I'm just going to create some kind of shape, which could be our ship. Again, I'll add a mirror modifier on that. And we'll stick with that for the moment. That'll give us the opportunity to demonstrate how some of this works. So there's our ship. We'll turn our camera on. Okay, so now we need to give some materials to things. So we'll give the ground a new material, which we'll just call ground. I'm not too worried about the colors, but in case we want to just be able to differentiate during preview renders, we'll give it something. So we'll give it a slight yellowy color, and we'll copy that color into the viewport display color. And then we'll give the ship some material, and we'll give that a light blue color, I think. These are not the colors we're going to actually see necessarily either. So looking through the camera, that's the view we're going to see. So if I rendered that now, this is set to EV, remember. The only light we've got in the scene is the surrounds here, this very mid-gray background, which isn't what I'm going to want anyway. So we now need to turn on freestyle. So I'm going to go to the render properties, and under EV, you'll notice there's a box for turning on freestyle. So I'll tick that. And in there are a couple of options. I didn't feel the need to change anything in here, but obviously you can affect the thickness of the lines that Freestyle generates here. And I found Absolute was the best one for my application. So if we just press F12 now, no obvious change at the moment until it's finished the secondary render. And then we've got lines appearing. So already we started to get something interesting. Now you'll notice we haven't got a line through here, and there are only so many lines on the ground plane. And I'll get into why that is in a moment, but suffice to say, it's to do with these angles. So if I was to select these two edges and scale on the X in a little bit, they will become sharper edges, and then do the opposite for these two down here, scale on the X out a bit, and now do a render once it's done the freestyle bit. Yes, we've now got a line appearing down here, but no lines here. Again, because the angles are relatively gentle. So depending on where you want them, you can obviously change the geometry or you can change some other parameters. So I'm just going to deepen that a little bit, which will increase that angle, and render that. So it's still not quite significant enough to show up. We've got them showing up in some cases, but you can see the direction we're going in with this now. So the next thing we need to do is work on this as a render. Now you might want an animation that looks like that, but that's not the look we're going for with this particular tutorial. So if we go to layer properties, you'll have this available initially. And if we start to minimize some of these down here, we've got some freestyle options available. So here's the angle that will affect what lines are shown. So if we try 75, and I'll go to a new slot so that we can compare, and you can see here's the new one and here's the old one. So that's 134 degrees, that's 75 degrees. So if I put this up and render that, and now you can see we've got a lot more of the geometry being highlighted compared to one. So that's obviously too much. Obviously the max angle is actually 180, so it's flat basically. If it's anything other than flat, it gets highlighted. So by 125, and you can see that's getting up there. 134 was what we had, so we could go for 145. And again, slightly more. You can see there's a few extra in there. I ended up using the default, so I'll just put it back to 134. So here you can define line sets. I did experiment with this, but eventually decided not to use this. This is so that you can have different styles of line, which might be perhaps continuous lines like these or dotted lines, and use those differently. I didn't need to do that, so I ended up just going with the one default line style. Then under edge types, you get different options for how the lines themselves work, and you can try different things. So if I took out crease, for example, and then rendered that, you can see that's a bit different as well. That's how it was and that's how it is. But again, I ended up sticking with the defaults on that, so that's easy. And then we come down to strokes. This is selecting the shape of the end of the line. So if we were to look here, is it a squared off edge? Is it a butted edge, which is slightly rounded, or a completely round edge, sort of circular at the end? Again, I went with the default. In general, mostly I've stuck with defaults. So here's the freestyle color. Let's see what happens if we change from the default on that. We'll go to white. And you can see we've now got a white line, but we can also add a modifier, and that'll become significant in a moment. So I'm going to leave it on white, and I'm going to go back to my material. So we're on the floor at the moment. I don't need to do anything with the principal shader, but if I scan down here, we've now got a freestyle option. And opening that up, you can see we've got a black line color with a transparent background. So I'm going to change that to a nice bright orange color, and we'll render again. No change. And this is what could catch you out. So if we go back to our layers, under freestyle color, I'm going to add a modifier, which is the material modifier. And then I'm going to accept the defaults, and I'm going to render again. And suddenly my line color is coming through. That can catch you out, that one. And so I'll do the same now for the ship. We'll just go to the material, we'll go to the freestyle properties, and we'll give that a nice light sort of color. And because I've already changed the layers, I don't need to go back there. So we've now got our objects highlighted in these colored lines. But how do we get rid of the infill? So I'm going to open up another window, and I'm going to go to the compositor, click use nodes. And by default, this is just taking everything and rendering it. And then under the freestyle options under layers, I also need to turn on render as pass. And you notice I get a new option under render layers. So if I now just take that output straight to my composite output, initially I don't seem to get anything, but I'm just going to re-render. And now we've got our strokes or lines on top of a transparent background. So an easy fix for that transparent background, I'm just going to add a color mix node. Drop that in there. I'm going to put my freestyle output into the bottom, and it's actually already fixed it. I set my background color to black, but because of the way this works, it's already done it. So we've now got our vector graphics showing on top of a nice black background. Now, one of the things we're used to doing with an Eevee render is turning on things like bloom. However, I'll turn it on there. That does not work for a freestyle render. We have to do it the old-fashioned way, which is putting filters on. So let's do that. So I'm going to add a filter, which is a glare filter. I'm going to set it to fog glow. I'm going to set the threshold to zero. So that means relatively dim things will glow. And you can see we've now got a fog or glow around the edges. And then I wanted to brighten everything up, or brighten all the lines up. So all I'm going to do is take a copy of that mix node, but change it to an add node, and then just take the image in there twice. So if I mute that node, you can see slightly dimmer, unmute it, and it's slightly brighter. And I actually ended up doing that three times just to get the really intensely bright image that I felt you would get from a cathode ray tube and a vector display. And that is all you need to do. Obviously, I animated it as well and did a few other things, but in terms of achieving that vector graphics look, that's all there is to it. I just wanted to do this tutorial because there are a few little gotchas in there that took me a little while to work out. So I hope you found that useful. If you did, let me know. I will upload this original file for my Patreons to use. Otherwise, I will see you in the next tutorial. Thanks a lot.